second-tier superpower following Brexit claim spider. Sign up to receive our rundown of the days direct to your inbox. Subscribe. When you subscribe, we will use the information you provide to send you these newsletters. Sometimes they'll include recommendations for other related newsletters or services. Our privacy notice explains more about how we use your data and your rights. You can unsubscribe at any. Professor Willem Beider explained the world experienced a net loss when the UK left the EU due to the diminished ability to conduct trade. He warned the UK will struggle with its bargaining power, but added the EU is still behind many other world actors in terms of economic affairs. Professor Beider added that the UK leaving the EU could allow China to have more bargaining power again. Speaking during a YouTube show on Narcissi Limited, George Galloway asked the professor of international affairs, where does the EU stand on the global stage? Well, it would be on a second tier after the US and increase with a diffused and non-unified voice speaking on key issues that affect plus 27 countries. I would say that the EU is now a second tier superpower in economic affairs. Mr. Galloway followed up and asked, will Russia and other emerging powers take advantage of division between Britain and Europe? EU lashes out at Ireland and warns of payback. Professor Beider replied, I wouldn't call Russia a superpower, China yes, but remember, the fact that the EU is diminished by the UK's departure doesn't mean it is a corresponding gain for other regions and other. There is a net global loss in terms of your ability to create wealth and to interact in constructive ways in a range of markets for a wide variety of goods and services. So I would say yes, the bargaining position of China when dealing with the EU has been strengthened by the UK's vaccine crisis managed terribly by EU, says Charles Henri Galois. During the show, panelists discussed how the EU is faring after Brexit, with Lib Dem candidate Jonathan Fryer warning that member states are starting to go their own. He cited Hungary, who has made vaccine deals outside of the EU vaccination procurement program as they are fed up with. Hungary has made deals with Russia and China to import their vaccines and is the first EU country to. Don't miss Brexit Live. Netherlands gloats after poaching UK firms. Live blog. Finally, UK to scrap EU rules and put British businesses first. Insight. Macron allies plea for UK to rejoin EU. Brexit is not good for us. Analysis. Trending. Serbia has also followed suit as, despite not being part of the EU yet, they were expecting doses from a bloc but have independently secured vaccines from Russia, China and also North America. The Balkan country was able to roll out its vaccine program much quicker than the rest of Europe and has one of the highest population vaccine rates on the continent. Mr. Fryer added that German Chancellor Angela Merkel would be stepping down this year, leaving a small he believes France or Italy will try to reposition themselves as the dominant power within the EU.